Hey guys, welcome back to the series where we are taking things back to basics to help out all you first-time travellers. And today we're going to be talking about liquids, specifically liquids in your hand luggage. Most of you know, if you've ever taken a flight, that liquids are restricted very strictly on planes these days. In general, you are only allowed to carry liquids in a container no more than 100 milliliters in capacity. And these bottles must fit within a clear bag like this. And don't forget, you have to pull your liquids out at security for inspection. Even if the amount of liquid in this is only 100 mils, it is still going to be confiscated from you, and all liquid must fit within a bottle that is 100 mils or less, like this. So this is no good no matter how much is in it. So what do you do if you're traveling for more than just a few days? Buy some very small refillable travel bottles that are obviously 100 mils or less. These are actually 60 mil size bottles and these are really good. They're silicone. I've had them for years and they've done me really well. I'll link them down below. Then you just fill these up with your favorite shampoo, conditioner, or body wash from back home. Then you just pop your liquids into your clear bag. Now, normally security will give you one of these bags that's actually like TSA approved or something in size. But like if you take a little bag like this, and so long as it's sealable and clear, they're normally okay. If not, they'll give you a bag, you empty it out, you put it into theirs, not a problem, no hassle, no need to stress about that. So once you throw your little liquids in there and seal it up, that is what you'll show to them at security. Now, once you get to your destination, you can pick up full-size bottles of shampoo or body wash or things like that and keep these on you and use these until your next flight. Then for your next flight, you just take whatever's left in your big bottles, put them back into your travel-size bottles, and voila, you get on your next flight, you're not breaking any rules, but you're keeping yourself stocked up on any cosmetics you like. Now, there are a few ways to hack this because, for example, wet wipes do not count towards your liquid allowance. So things like cleansing wipes for your face or wet wipes to keep refreshed, instead of taking something like liquid, which will take up space in this very small bag, then taking something like this will mean it doesn't have to go in there. Also, Lush, the brand, do a whole range of shampoo bars, and as it's a solid shampoo, it's not liquid. It doesn't count towards that either, and I would highly recommend them. They're fantastic and they last so many washes. These are the rules that I know, these are the rules that I travel by and have for the past 4 years, and they've done me well. However, I would always recommend, because they're always changing the rules, check with the airline you're flying with to see how much liquid you are allowed through the airport, onto the plane, whatever you need to know, just double check. But this is your kind of mini guide to taking liquids on in your carry-on. I hope this has helped you out. Have you actually ever come across any issues when you've been at airport security with liquids? Let me know down below. I'd love to hear your stories. Don't forget to check out the playlist I've linked down below. This series has got a lot more episodes with a lot more information, and my channel has over 500 videos full of information and vlogs from around the world. So make sure you check them out. And if you're new, I'd love to have you as a little psycho. So please hit subscribe if you've enjoyed this, and I will see you tomorrow for another episode of Basics of Backpacking. All right, bye-bye.